Well, welcome everybody. It's another talk, another Let's Talk About on JustUs Rejects. This one, codename Chicago Street Dog. Mm. That's right, guys.
Code name. Don't put ketchup on that bad boy.
No, we do not.
No ketchup at
no,
all.
No, not at all. Not at all. Now, can't do the show without big men's co-workers, Zach the Mac, Drag Jar RJ. Zach the Mac, say what's up to the fans.
Yeah, you know what's up, guys. We're here, and dudes and dudettes, if you will. What's up? You know, we're here talking trash, talking crap, talking the best smack of all down.
That's right.
You know what I mean? So, Director, go ahead.
Hello, you reject with me, Director RJ.
Now, moving on to Let's Talk About, we got good questions to talk about and discuss today. So let's dive into it. Now, will we see Britt Baker, versus Thunder Rosa for the women's AEW title? Let's talk about it, Director RJ. I know we're fans. I want to see Thunder Rosa in that mix. What do you think?
I think it's time for her to get that title.
She has the background for it, man.
The only sad part is that we're so close to All Out. It's not. I wish it would have happened at All Out between her and Britt Baker, but I think Britt Baker is injured at the moment.
And I feel like I think she is too, and I can see that they're just trying to like milk it and kind of like wait it out just to see how she feels before she gets back in the ring in action. But also, it kind of gives time for Thunder Rosa to get her background a little bit more and get her momentum blowing, which I feel like it is happening because the last two matches, her social media status is kind of blowing up. Her makeup for wearing Mexico colors, as well as her, what's it called, the face painting that she does for the skeleton face or the De La Huentes type of style. It's blowing. It's moving. She has a movement. She's had it there. So I like it. But also, like we discussed, AJ Lee could possibly be coming in.
AJ Lee doesn't want to wrestle no more, apparently. Because of her body has already taken too many injuries.
Has it?
Allegedly.
I got you.
But I think in reality, I feel like she might have said that because of WWE when she, like, when they were asking her to come back to WWE, she's like,
wear and tear.
Nah, I want to do it no more.
I don't feel good.
AEW's more
my back.
Thank you. So I mean, like, it would be a highlight role for Thunder Rosa to kind of get into. So I feel like Thunder Rosa's having a good run. Like I said before, when she joined AEW, I thought that she would definitely be one of the main women in there and leading the way. I feel like if they would have finally put the title on her, she's gonna last a while and she's gonna build that women's division well.
We're missing one person that might show up in AEW that could put on a heck of a match with Thunder Rosa. Actually, two wrestlers.
Who? Give it to
Tessa Blanchard.
Who's that?
Blanchard. She's one of the most popular women wrestlers all around the world right now.
Okay.
Ooh, and great. Ruby Riott.
Ooh, Ruby Riott. You're right. That would be a good match setup between them two. Yes. That's so true. I mean, she did her trailer already.
Yeah.
And she's been doing random trailers where they think that it could be leading her to AEW. And this final match could be set up. Britt Baker loses the title to Thunder Rosa after she jumps for it, when she kills a little bit back up, and then gives Ruby Riott that implosion within AEW and sets off a good freaking rivalry for the women's division. Like I said before, this is a good setup to build on that division and push them in ways that they need to be pushed right now at the moment. This is actually better. That momentum for AEW is moving, and it's on a hot train right now, heading straight. So it's awesome. All right, moving along. Adam Cole could be All Elite soon. Let's talk about it. I did not know this. Director RJ, explain it to me.
There's rumors about Adam Cole. He didn't sign to another contract with WWE.
Mm-hmm.
His wife is in AEW, Baker. So I think he might be heading to AEW now.
Could be. He sees how they're shining out, sees how things are doing.
I mean, AEW is up and rising.
That's true. Somebody has
definitely up
and rising. Wrestling is way better than AEW.
Right. It's because it's based, they're focusing on the wrestling. They're not focusing on the soap opera stuff.
Yeah.
And it makes it even better.
You need that.
Now, my issue with that is that they had, what's the president that's in WWE, the Khan? Which Khan is that one?
Oh, he's not related to the Khan.
Okay. But his thing is, he wants to create a 5-hour show, a 4-hour show for Raw now, and a 5-hour show for SmackDown, saying that this could help them out even more. I don't think so, dude. It's not. This soap opera stuff is not going to help out. They need to focus on the wrestling like they focused on it years ago in Attitude Era, But even at that, in WCW, when they were really on the rise, they were focusing on the wrestling,
right,
not focusing on the background commentary and the movie fake movie stuff.
Nobody likes the soap opera.
No, then, I mean, good entertaining when they did certain scenes. Not only a soap opera,
but then you have to go perform and wrestle against each other, and you feel like it's like, oh, I respect you, so I'm not gonna hurt you. We don't want that. We want to be like, yo, I want your title. I want to beat it.
Thank you. And I want it now. Respect.
We're gonna fight. So,
yes,
right. So,
I like that.
That's why. Yeah.
So Adam Cole, if he goes there, but he just needs to. I guess the good part about it is it's the focus on the wrestling, where he himself, you can see it, he's more of that focus on wrestling. I'm not focused on me being an actor. I'm focused on me being a wrestler. That's my niche. That's my butter. Let's go there. So we can see that. All right. Can we see Daniel Bryan and Bray Wyatt joining AEW? Let's talk about it, Director. All right, Jay, again, because he's my wrestling guy. He's definitely with me more than Zach DeMack. He follows, but he's the watcher. You know, gets the highlights and stuff. Like, so
you can check the Twitter for the updates on that AEW. I'm definitely there updating it.
There you go.
So I now think I catch on to AEW, man. I haven't watched much, but I've been catching up little by little.
Yeah, I've been watching a little bit, especially after the whole.
Director's seen some of the tweets too. He knows they're there. They have a lot of, you know, they got a lot of action. They got a lot of people coming in. Right. True. I'm telling you right.
So now pertaining to Bray Wyatt and Daniel Bryan, be good. Daniel Bryan has been, I think, referenced quite a few times in there, but I think even be doper if Bray Wyatt does jump ship and go to AEW, where he loves the wrestling part of it, like anyone says, AEW is focusing on that. And if he brings in the Fiend, that would even be more crazier.
The Fiend versus Sting.
Oh, look at that! I gotta see my favorite guy there. I gotta see my guy there like that.
Ooh, He can still go.
He amazes me, dude.
That amazes me. The highlights
in there.
He's almost like at a point where he's the face of AEW, and I was like, this guy's still relevant like that. Yes. Like, so I'm impressed. You know, shout out to Sting.
Even though Sting, I got a shout out to you, my man Sting. Can we lower the price a little bit on your cameo thing on there? On cameo.com, if you guys ever look on there, Sting's about $500 for a cameo. Right now, Jesus. I ain't got that money, man. Could you get a little cheaper for me?
Hey, how much?
So I can wish you for a happy birthday to me?
How much is it for the red face thing?
Oh! I did not say that.
You get a discount. Half off.
Can you get a discount
for that? How much for Joker's thing?
Oh, even better. 20% off. 20% off. Please,
we'll
something like that.
We'll take all discounts. You take coupons?
We'll
take them all.
Buy one, get one half off, please. Mm-hmm. Something like that. Mm-hmm. But, you know, all in all, you're right. Sting could still definitely go. He is highlighted in there. And the fact that he's connected with
Darby Allin,
you can definitely see the growth in him, and also the embodiment of just perform in the ring, will then thus help other wrestlers want to wrestle you and create these type of fantasy matches, which has always been the respectable thing of Sting.
I think that would be more interesting, because what if Bray Wyatt, when he shows up, of course, I don't know if he could keep the name Bray Wyatt or not.
Correct.
So he might have to have a new name, but right. The Fiend, I think he could keep it, or he could use a different name, but still the same character. What if when Bray Wyatt shows up in AEW, he takes control of Darby Allin?
Mm.
There's a Dark Order thing that his best, you know, one of our greatest wrestlers who passed away way back in the day.
Yeah.
Luke Harper,
mm-hmm.
I forget his real name, but when he passed away, he had this group called the Dark Order.
Yes.
And Eric Rowan is still part of it, I believe.
Wow.
So Bray Wyatt could take over that group.
True. Very true.
That's true.
That is true. That is true. Okay.
And, you know, you have if so much. If he does, I wouldn't be mad.
No, I wouldn't either. Yeah.
Now, Daniel Bryan, on the other hand, you look at matches that are going to be crazy if that guy shows up.
No lie.
Kenny Omega.
Yes.
CM Punk.
That's true.
Christian.
Yes.
Cody Rhodes.
That's right.
Darby Allin. And then the one I really want to see him against, Orange Cassidy.
Oh, that would be good. That would be good matches. No lie, I think AEW is just on the rise, man. This is an AEW type of show right now, because everything is about AEW and respectively so, because they are on the rise. And none to say, like we all said, WWE and them competition. There is no competition. They're in their own fields. But at the moment right now, what AEW has greatly been going for them is that they're focusing on the wrestling. They're focusing on the wrestler buildup. That's the main and purpose of why they're on the rise right now. That's even better. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's cool. Next question, Ric Flair.
Woo.
What's that one last match? Could Sting be his opponent? Let's talk about it, you guys.
Go ahead.
He wants this to be his last match?
He wants Ric Flair to have one last match in AEW, and could Sting be that guy to give him that last match?
I personally think the idea of it is awesome. I would love to see it. It's definitely going to be a fan favorite. You can confidently say it's one of my top freaking five favorites, so... For both of them to be, yes. For both of them to go for, I mean, obviously it's not Sting's last bout, but if Ric Flair wants to go out with a hurrah against Sting, I mean, yeah, why not? I really don't think anybody else at the time is in his really realm to go against them besides really Sting. I mean,
no, not really.
Other
than Jake the Snake Roberts or DDP.
I was going to say my AEW roster is not quite up to date, but as far as I know, anybody I can think of off the top of the head that's still wrestling, it maybe.
No.
I mean, what? Maybe John Cena because he just made a comeback, so he could be like old school versus new school type of thing.
They would have to jump into
it. Yeah, oh, but yeah, so we could do a crossover if you want to stretch it.
You want to stretch it. They've been saying it, we'll talk about it.
AKA SmackDown versus Raw. I mean, you know what I'm saying? If you want to stretch it, but right, if Ric Flair just wants to go out with the hurrah, I say let him go against Sting. Hell yeah. I mean, we're talking vintage Sting, though, you know, with the bat, with the black leather, long, you know, drench. And we're talking. We're talking feathers and around that Ric Flair. He's got to come out with. Right. He's got to come out off. Right. It's got to be a vintage fight. Maybe, you know, make it a main event. Make it a TLC. Make it pretty bloody if you want to. Why not? I mean, Ric Flair is definitely a top, you know, top three, you know, number one wrestlers in the world, I believe. So that guy should go out with the hurrah. If not. So definitely. I'd be okay with that. I'm with it.
What about you, Director RJ? What do you think of that?
Let them fight.
Let them
fight. Lord, I gotta be SG3 in this one.
Shout out SG3. We love you, buddy. We love you, man. We miss you.
I gotta be SG3 in this one. I gotta be a version of him. I'm pretty sure he'll probably be like okay with this. But I literally do not want to see this. I don't want this to happen at all. You're setting up for failure in the sense of everyone being out of sync and, you know, the bumps are going to be so weird and it's not,
you know what?
You know, it's going to be funky. Now,
I just thought about it too, not to cut you off, but I did remember him fighting Shawn Michaels and it was kind of sad at one point.
Thank you. I mean, that was his final wrestling match. The final goodbye.
And I hate to cut off,
but then when
he went
to TNA and he had all those weird matches, like it really was a joke.
I think
that's why he wants to have one last hurrah.
How many last hurrahs?
We've seen a lot of interviews from Ric Flair, and you can cut it. And every wrestler in the world can literally say, I at least want to have that one match always. And same thing Damian with Taker, with him having his matches, he kept wanting to be able to go out and finally give it that last match feeling where I gave it all, everyone enjoyed it, it was perfect, and I'm done. I'm saying my goodbye.
I think that's the thing that's happening with Flair, is that he's looking at the fact that you went out with Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania 24.
It was epic, and it was one of the greatest matches.
Ending of all matches you've ever had.
Correct.
But you had that itch, and you're like, you know, I got to get paid. I'm going to go here to TNA.
Thank you.
I mean, he was dropping videos with Migos and everything.
Yeah, so he went to TNA. He had his matches. But like I said, you know, he wasn't. Those matches weren't compared to what Shawn Michaels
did. Never near.
No.
Especially with the Hulk. See, that's my thing. Especially with Hulk Hogan, of all people, you had the matches, and they both look silly as hell.
Well, it's because you're comparing apples to oranges, you know? Shawn Michaels is one of the greatest, and I'll say it right now, you know, SG3 and Alex might want to record this and play it over and over if you hear it. Shawn Michaels is one of the greatest performers of all time.
He's a heartbreak kid we're talking about. Yeah.
That's right.
He, not only can he tell a story outside of the ring, but he can tell a story inside the ring.
Love to have seen a match between CM Punk and Shawn Michaels A full-on match.
I got Shawn Money and Shawn Michaels.
Well, if they do like a dream match for Shawn Michaels. Cool. How we did with Bret Hart for next WrestleMania. We'll definitely. Do like Shawn Michaels lineup.
Yes, that would be definitely what's up.
But yeah, that's get why you. In my Shawn mind Michaels is my boy. And it's kind of like Tyson, you know. Tyson, when he went out, he didn't feel happy about it. He came back because he had that itch. He fought Roy Jones Jr. You saw what happened there. Mm-hmm. I think Flair just wants to have that one last match to walk out, you know, like saying, okay, this is good. This is a badass match. People loved it. They're going to remember this last match because the last ones I've had were all crappy.
Yeah.
Well, so it's like fixing up a wrong.
Right. I got you. It just, it's weird. It's just weird, you guys. I don't know if I want to see this. Like, I don't mind it being, I don't know. It's like, I don't think that them being together would make it any better. I think they need somebody who can carry the load and do the performing more so than doing the wrestling. So, huh?
No.
Tag team
would be decent.
I feel like Sting, Sting is going to hold the momentum in the fight.
Well, that's what I mean, though. But I don't think he's also... Like, it can't be that long of a match in the first place when it comes to carrying the match. Like,
because of one person, they could do a tag team because of these two people.
Andrade and what's-his-face?
And Darby Allin.
And Darby Allin. Yeah, they're going to be carrying the matches, of course, for the most part. And then Sting and Ric Flair are going to be involved. Yes. But I don't know if you're going to consider that your fight. That's the thing. What's the point of doing that if you can't? Like, I'm okay with him, Ric Flair, being the manager to Andrade and doing their little thing or whatever. Yeah. Same thing as Sting doing to Darby Allin. Mm-hmm. But the essence of saying that that's my final match, don't say it like that. I'm just I'm just enjoying myself. Don't give me the final match statement. Because if you're going to give me the final match statement, I'm expecting you to perform. I'm expecting you to be at your best level. Yeah. And you being at that age...
Top criteria type.
I'm sorry, Ric Flair. You're not. And I get it because you've been in this business from...
He's not.
You've been in this business since you're 18. In all respects, no hating, no disrespect or anything like that, Ric Flair. You have by far, if I'm not mistaken, the number one best wrestler in the world. And from then on, the most iconic one. Like, wrestling is you. Let's put it that way. And it just goes to show that you need to just say, I'm good. I had my time. 16 times, man. You've been all over all wrestling industries.
And
everywhere.
The only one out of all those guys that are in that company and in the other company that went to North Korea.
Exactly. And then at that, you could finally say you went to North Korea. Yeah. Like, you wrestled the best one there.
And Noki.
Inoki, so it's like you wrestled the best of the best of the best of the
and
best.
Not just that, the weirdest part of it all, when he was in Korea, did you realize that was the only match in Korea that put on, like, that Koreans were actually...
Actual show that they were hyped up for.
Yeah, because of Inoki, and Flair knew how to sell it so good, where Inoki was the good guy in this match.
Right.
People were wanting
even though
Inoki.
He was somewhat the bad guy over there on their end.
Yeah.
So it's like, man, it was... Yeah, I don't know, it's... That's what I mean. I cannot...
Unless they do not a professional match style, but street fight.
But again, it's going to be weird because now you're... I don't know.
The only thing they could do that would match, that won't hurt them much, is if they do something kind of like the Last Ride type match.
Possibly. That's true.
Not Last Ride. Boneyard match.
Yes. Maybe. Something similar to that where I think that could be even
cinematic.
Dope. Because what they did with Sting with Darby Allin, they did a cinematic one, and that was even dope. That was actually on par. You remember that?
No.
You should watch it. Because it was actually on par between... A lot of fans were happy with that because it was on par to what was done with...
Taker and AJ Styles.
Exactly. It was kind of like their bark back, basically, you would have to say. So, that makes sense. Now, we'll see. We'll see how it goes, you guys. I don't know... If they do give us something, they have to give it the respect. And I really hope if AEW is on board and the way they've done things, they've trusted the wrestlers doing their stuff. This is the one where I have to say you have to put your foot down and kind of say yes or no to certain scenarios in case they put out there. Because their age is something of a concern at this moment right now, especially with Ric Flair's health. So
yeah,
we'll have to see how it goes. All right, guys. Now, last and final question. Now, in Chicago, just recently, if I'm not mistaken, it was last Friday, right? Yeah. Last Friday. Woo! Man. August 23. No.
21.
On my birthday.
21st.
August 20th.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a Friday. My birthday was 21st. So August 20th. August 20th, Friday night. AEW Dynamite, no, Rampage.
Oh,
Rampage,
yeah.
AEW Rampage.
Your boy.
The best in the world shows up in Chicago. Yeah. In Chicago. Now, when you heard this song, when you heard this beat, you guys, not there yet. It's getting there. But when you heard this little guitar solo just come out,
I wasn't even there. CM who? What? What's his name? I just did that.
He's so cute.
No lie, you guys. When that song dropped, everyone was blowing up, including myself. I put that on the big screen. I recorded it, and I got it recorded on Hulu. I can replay it as many times as I want to. And nonetheless, it was by far the coolest debut and return, if I might add, to wrestling industry ever.
He's not getting a belt. He's not getting a belt.
Go get a belt. He topped everybody. He's topped every return, and topped any debut in wrestling.
Yeah, the top part is WWE tried to top them with their own returns. And
the next night on August 21st, at SummerSlam,
and everyone's like, CM Punk did it better.
Way better.
No, I'm not going to lie.
And it was a smaller crowd.
I'm not going to lie. It broke Twitter, guys. It did break Twitter.
Thank you.
Because I was on Twitter scrolling through it. And
broke the net.
These guys, the gentleman here, the Tony the Kid director, not like I'm not crazy about AEW, but I know I was on Twitter. And believe me, that's all that came in the timeline.
Thank you.
Return.
Yes.
And then the first meme that they dropped was him sitting Indian style with the mic in his hand.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, he's back. He's back, for real.
Yes.
So, yeah.
I was throwing shade to WWE.
Yeah,
him
exactly.
I wanted Thomas to tell a story. He sits down Indian style like he did at WWE.
That was the first meme
when
they
cut off the mic.
That's the first thing they did, though.
Yeah.
So I saw it on Twitter. He definitely came back with a vengeance, yeah.
Yeah, and that boy was crying, emotional. Everything was flowing through. You could tell the respect and love there from everybody.
Yeah, he was there.
That shirt sold out everywhere.
Yeah, and the freaking ice cream bars there were gone.
You can find a John Cena shirt anywhere. You can find a Roman Reigns shirt anywhere you want.
But you didn't even see John Cena wear the T-shirt trying to throw shade at CM Punk too as well. The Mario, the Mario type of logo where CM Punk did it for himself, but then John Cena comes out with that too. Stupid.
And they still try to sell, you know, Becky Lynch and Brock Lesnar. They came out. I bet you their shirts didn't even get near the amount of shirts that CM Punk did.
No, not at all. He was not at back, all. Full effects.
I mean, I give it to WWE doing stuff like that because those were good returns as far as the CM Punk, the Becky Lynch one. That was a good return. I think she was bound to come back. And it being SummerSlam, this would have been the most respectable place to put her back.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we came to Brock Lesnar, though. My only thing is, why bring him out against Roman? Should have been coming out against Bobby. Because Roman had no shout-out to Brock Lesnar at all whatsoever. But Bobby Lashley has been coming after Brock Lesnar for so many months now, talking smack about him, and yet he comes out against Roman.
Because they're saving Brock and Bobby for WrestleMania.
But that doesn't that makes sense. But then you would also be like, then why involve Brock now?
Well, hype it up, I guess.
Why hype it up?
Probably because Paul Heyman was Brock's manager.
And
so you need something to keep Roman busy for a while.
Oh, until WrestleMania where The Rock comes out. That's true.
Yeah.
So
and then Brock will go to.
Is he coming to allegedly Rock? Rock's going to be.
They think that this will be his Brock's final match. Like, because Rock's never had his final match. Like, due respect to anybody else.
Of course,
he's never had his final match.
And he's still.
So.
Still talking about
it's still relevant. So, in essence, with Roman, the way his tribal chief status has come about, like, this would be that time frame for him to go against The Rock and say, I am the tribal chief. I am carrying our family name. And beyond, which Roman still has a good another 5 more years in wrestling, in my opinion.
I gotta say, if The Rock goes to WrestleMania and wins, you know he's bringing his daughter in the ring.
I don't know about that, but I can see his daughter coming out though, even though she's in wrestling. You know that, right?
Yeah. Well, no, I was talking about his youngest.
Oh, no, no, no. His newborn. His oldest daughter.
But yeah.
His oldest daughter's in the training session.
Yes, she does. I know that she does. I know that she tried out. I know that. That's what I was.
Well, no, she's in it now. Okay, she's currently still practicing now because The Rock actually appeared in there talking with the team and said, you know, this is awesome.
Right.
I can't believe my daughter's actually doing this. This is great. She looks good.
Hey.
Nice. But
she coming. Then he's definitely gonna be charging.
Right.
He's
but like we said, CM Punk's return by far the best.
I don't like. And be like, I'm gonna retire. You gonna get the money, right? You got it. You're stepping where I took off, right? You got it.
You good? Do I need to come back again?
Do I gotta come back for the tag team? We got it.
House tag championship.
Right. We'll get it. You got it. I'll take a seat.
I'm gonna act.
I'm gonna continue my moves.
Right. I'm gonna act.
I gotta be Black Adam. So it's good. It's all right. It's getting there. But also, CM Punk, great return, John. What do you think?
Damn, dude. For him to face against Darby Allin, that's gonna be interesting. I haven't seen much about Darby Allin, but I heard a lot about him.
Mm-hmm.
I heard all the things that people have said about the things that he's done in the ring. That's a perfect opponent for CM Punk.
But I want to see CM Punk in the ring a few times before he wrestles. So I want to literally see CM Punk wrestle a little bit before he gets on the ring. But I like the fact that at least he's training in the ring to get used to it again.
I was thinking the one match that I would like CM Punk to do, and because they're both good on the mic, the guy that's feuding with Jericho right now.
Oh, MJW or something like
MJF?
That? MJF? Yeah, MJF. Yeah. I agree, too. Like, I didn't realize how good he was on the mic until that fight, that one against Chris Jericho recently in the last show. When he's like, it's rubbed the boots off of me or something like that. Like,
Chris Jericho, not to get you, but has Chris Jericho been doing very good with the AEW?
Well, he lost his match. Remember that five labors thing that we're talking about before?
Oh, no, I do. Yes,
yeah,
I do.
He lost against... He won off the last four up until the main guy he got to that he was supposed to.
Yeah.
And he lost that match.
It's fucking
but I think that just, like I said before when we were talking about the chats, I think this is his final run.
So not off subject, but on subject. So you guys think that it would be a CM Punk versus Chris Jericho in the AEW history? Before one of them?
Before
because Chris this was Jericho relevant. Retires? We talked about this a couple shows ago.
That's true.
So, true. On the subject, but off the subject, you guys think it would be a... And CM Punk's here, so.
Yeah, right. I don't know.
No? Jericho's retiring, but this last match, he said if he loses, he goes to the announce table.
Right.
Yeah.
I mean, he's got a great voice. I would love him. He's cool. I fuck with him. Remember the Dark Side of the Ring? He was great for.
That's one of those, like, I have a feeling that's one of those, like, swerves.
You don't think he can beat CM Punk, Director?
I'm asking you. I think they'll tie it up. They'll go 1-1. You know what I mean? So and like I feel like he could win the first one, but then CM Punk win the second one to make sure he's out for good. But you know, Jericho's got a big ego.
He's not going to just lose and be out for good.
That's true. But I don't know what makes them cross paths at the moment right now. That's the only thing. The way their storylines are kind of set up,
gotcha.
Like I don't know what will make them cross paths like that just yet.
Gotcha. And you guys said that AEW is not too much about the...
The movie scenery stuff.
And I respect that. So if they don't cross paths, then it is what it is.
They did cross paths in WWE.
Yeah.
Right, that's what I'm saying. But with AEW, if they don't and if Jericho's going to retire, then it is what it is.
It's just that Trish Jericho's, he's big.
He got wily.
Even though he's like muscle like, big.
Hey, it's when he goes for the loss of Jericho, he's like, ugh.
It's just that his wrestling moves are... His wrestling moves are set up, you know what I'm saying?
That leg. And then he's like, ah! Is he like that? Okay.
Because I remember he tried to do the wall, not the wall of Jericho,
is
but
he
the
hitting
flip.
Backflips off the...
He tried to do the backflip, but he landed on his head.
So, no!
Yes.
So I don't know.
I think it was one of those times where he was thinking of it, it's time for me to just hang up the boots.
Okay. Yeah, and just sit back and relax.
Because he has his Rock Band right now.
Still going hard.
Yeah, okay. He's I think he has like a...
I mean, he just went to a...
Executive office role in AEW. Right.
Okay, right. Yeah. And he just went to a five-guy thing you just said.
Five labors.
So, if he didn't beat
but
that...
But also, the way how freaking TV show Dark Side of the Ring is rolling has him being the narrator of it.
That's what I was
It's still blowing
well.
Up.
Yeah,
it's even getting bigger.
Yeah, that's what I was getting
at. New season's coming out.
Okay, yeah. So if he does
not the season. second half of season three.
Yeah, the second half of the first of the third season.
So if he steps back and just if he does a commentator type of I mean, I'm sure all three of us love him here. He's good. We'll listen to him. He's probably one of the best commentators they've had. Since,
I have a feeling like he's not that old. He could still go like a round or two later on in the future.
Yeah, but my question was with CM Punk. CM Punk looked pretty primal. Oh, yeah. He looked pretty cut. Yeah, he looked pretty. I'm ready to do some high flying shit. So I was like,
he just needs a diet.
Yeah, exactly.
My boy got all white going there, man.
You know,
I think you're gonna be seeing Punk against guys like Orange Cassidy,
okay,
Darby Allin, Kenny Omega. That's what we're waiting. I'm waiting for Kenny Omega.
Yeah,
and Punk for the title.
Yeah,
John Moxley again.
Yeah, okay, that'd be good. So it's nice, good setup. But other than that, on that subject of CM Punk being in AEW now, the question, like we discussed earlier, would AJ Lee be joining him into the company soon? Do you think? I prospectively think so. Would she automatically jump in the ring and be his manager status type of thing? That's the question mark there. Would she be in the women's division? Question mark there. What type of role do you think she would have inside the company? What would you like to see her in, Dirk Darje?
If she can't wrestle anymore, then at least managing CM Punk would be good.
Mm-hmm.
Walk out with Punk for the ring and everything.
Yeah.
That'd be like the best thing she could do if she can't if she can't wrestle anymore.
Right? Yeah.
Other than that, probably that's the only thing I could think of for her, and probably a backstage writer. She's very smart.
That's true. Especially if they have her involved in the women's division, that would actually be a good setup for her to, I think, be successful. Because she's already been successful in WWE and carried that women's division for a good while. Even though when they had the Divas thing going on, that Divas title, that weird butterfly one, cheers. And they kind of set it up kind of funky. So it's a good setup. Wherever she's involved in the company, I think it's going to be successful for her. But I think for me, prospectively, I would like to see her involved definitely in the women's division. But the way I like how you said, as a writer, that'd be pretty dope. Yeah. That'd be pretty cool. I agree. I like that. So, yeah. All right, guys. Well, that concludes our questionnaires and our Let's Talk About It episode. That was a very fun AEW type of conversation because that was all the questions I noticed that were all about Director RJ. So good setup there. Good setup.
Thank you.
Other than that, Zach the Mac, any final thoughts, my man?
Yeah, honestly, if you guys do want up-to-date AEW information, I'm telling you, follow us on Twitter. You know, we be out here, ReJects Rundown at Twitter. You know what I'm saying? RJR. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Rundown. You guys can follow us, love us, give us feedbacks on anything. I got wrestling updates, NFL updates, NBA updates, Talk About It updates. We talk about it. We can discuss it. You can comment in. We can just talk crap. I don't care. We love you. You love us. Follow us on everything. All right. With that being said, thank you for listening in.
That's right.
Love you guys. Hashtag love.
Remember, a Chicago style hot dog.
Oh yes.
You do not put ketchup on a Chicago style hot dog.
Fair enough.
You do that in front of any man in Chicago. Any woman in Chicago.
It's equivalent to cheating in your relationship. Yeah, so just don't do it, alright?
You don't cheat. You just don't cheat when you're in Chicago.
Alright, you don't cheat.
That should be a slogan right there. You don't cheat when you're in Chicago.
That's right.
That's fair.
Yes. That's true.
That's fair. Agreed. Yes.
Play nice.
Yes. Agreed.
Alright, thank you.
All right, guys. Well, thank you guys for joining us, of course, on Let's Talk About It. Great question there, especially for AEW. Got to give respect to CM Punk's return. Definitely got to do that. But also, nonetheless, give respect to Thunder Rosa on her career path, being in AEW, and all the type of matches that could possibly be coming to her way. Congratulations. I think that's going to be, nonetheless, a successful run and an awesome industry in the women's division in there. So, see AEW beyond the rise. Thank you guys for joining us today, of course. Remember to follow us on the RejectRundown.com. We're on there. But also, you can find us on TikTok, of course, with Tony the Kid, sharing the news. But unless on Instagram, for sure, all the posts on there. The following is growing as we speak. I appreciate that, no doubt. We're up to 380, even though when we started off this year, we were like 202, if I'm not mistaken.
We're at 150 this year.
at 150 at the beginning of the freaking year, and we're up to 380 now. Look at that. It is, yes, it's small.
We jumped up 20 followers in Twitter.
But
we jumped up followers in TikTok.
There we go.
We jumped up followers on my own personal page.
There you go. You see what I mean? Like, we are, it's growing now. Nonetheless, we just appreciate the support. So let's put that way.
Most of my followers are the bots from the Austin Powers movies, but I don't care.
So it's all great. All love there. No lend less. Remember. One thing what's helped us out on Instagram, you guys, is the fact that you guys are not afraid to comment on any of the pictures, on any of the blogs that we share, and nonetheless, we will reply back. We share love when love is given back. So awesome.
Deleted there. My comment.
Oh, yours?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you said something stupid. So let's.
Okay.
Just a sidebar.
Just a sidebar. It made no sense of asking.
We're at the Rejects. We don't delete everything.
That
guys.
Question, unless if it's stupid, okay? You gotta really tick me off to get there. But other than that, it was
the same way too.
We had a personal side chat on there discussing that question that you asked, and it made no sense, my man. Mm-hmm. So, anyways, it's okay. But I love you guys. So you guys take it easy. Have a good night, and thank you for joining again. So y'all take care.